Chapter 5. When people rebel. What happened when the strict laws of the Britishers were implemented on the Indian population? How did the Indian kings, Indian Rajputs, Indian princes fought against them? How did the soldiers react? All these things we'll be discussing in this unit. First of all, Nawabs lose their power. Almost all the Nawabs lost their powers when they are fighting against the Britishers. Like this, the power got eroded. The Nawabs of Bengal, the Nawab of Awadh, the Nawabs always became defeated in the hands of the Britishers, either by any conspiracies or by the British strength. They defeated the Nawabs. Once the defeat happened, it has become very difficult for the Nawabs to come back. So slowly the power of the Nawabs got eroded away. Not only the Nawabs, the Indian kings, whoever tried to negotiate with the Britishers, failed to get their support. An example for that, Rani Lakshmibai, who tried and fought with them to recognize her alliance son, whom she has adopted. But they did not recognize her, and after she was defeated in the war, she was killed, and the kingdom of Jhansi was occupied by the Britishers. Not only this, Nana Saheb, who was the adopted son of Peshwa Baji Rao II, was asked to grant a pension, which was granted to his father, but they did not give him any recognition or neither granted him any pension. And Awadh was one of the territories annexed. One of the territories which was annexed in 1801, implementing the subsidiary alliance. The subsidiary alliance means you have to maintain the army of the Britishers in your court and pay for them some amount, the subsidiary grant. If you fail to pay the amount, the land from your territory will be grabbed off slowly as parts, as a compensation for what we did not pay the taxes. And moving on further, in 1856, the entire Awadh was taken over by the Britishers. And not only this, Mughal dynasty to end was another major target of the Britishers. Bahadur Shah Jafar was recognized as the last Mughal emperor, and Canning gave a statement that after Bahadur Shah Jafar, nobody else will be recognized as an emperor. They'll be recognized as princes only. And he was moved out of Red Fort, and separate arrangements were made for him to stay in the Delhi region. Like this, not only the Nawabs, from the Nawabs to the Mughals, everybody slowly or later lost their powers. It was Nawabs who lost their power first. The Nawab of Bengal, the Nawab of Awadh, the Nawab of Udh region, all of them lost their powers, one battle or the other battle. Next, many of the kings who tried to negotiate for their kingdoms to protect from the Britishers failed and could not negotiate with the Britishers, lost their kingdoms. Example, Rani Lakshmibai of Jhansi. Nana Saheb, who was the son of Peshwa Baji Rao II, also tried his level best for getting recognition from the Britishers, asking them to recognize him as a son because he is an adopted son and grant him the pension which is granted for his father. So he wants that to be continued after his father's death, which the Britishers denied. And Awadh was one such territory which was annexed in 1801, and a subsidiary alliance took place. Subsidiary alliance means sending an army, and for the maintenance of the army, we have to pay some amount to the company. This is called subsidiary alliance. But once you fail to pay payment for the subsidiary alliance, you lose your territory partly in parts. Like this, in 1801, Awadh was made as a subsidiary alliance. Then in 1856, completely the Awadh was taken over. The Mughal dynasty to end brought Bahadur Shah Jafar as the last ruler of the Mughal emperor. The Britishers also targeted the Mughals. They want the eradication of the Mughal emperor. So they gave a statement. The Mughal emperor will be Bahadur Shah Jafar, the last Mughal emperor. And after him, all the sons of Bahadur Shah Jafar will be called only princes. No more an emperor will be. So the Mughal rule emperors is going to come to an end with Bahadur Shah Jafar's regime. The peasants and the sepoys. How did the peasants react for the rebellion? And how did the peasants got involved? And why did the sepoys do the revolt? First one, the peasants and the zamindars are very particular, and they used to collect very high tax, and they used to maintain a very rigid method of collecting taxes at any cost. The taxes are very high, even though they don't have the proper rainfall, even though they didn't have the proper supply of water, though the crops failed, the people are forced to pay high taxes, and a rigid method was applied in collection of the taxes. So many of the farmers, peasants could not pay the taxes properly in time, and in turn, when what they have taken loan from the moneylenders, they could not repay back the moneylenders' loan also, resulting in losing their lands, what they have been cultivating from many generations. So the peasants and the farmers or the zamindars used to force the people, especially the farmers and the peasants, to pay high taxes, and they used to collect taxes with force, and this resulted in many of them failing to pay back the bank loans or the loans taken from the money lenders and losing off their lands and giving up their lands from which they have been cultivating for many generations together. Now, once we move out from the peasants, let us now move towards the sepoys. Indian sepoys are also dissatisfied, discontent. Why are they discontent? What is their problem? That is, new rules, religious sensibilities. There are certain new rules which force the Indian soldiers to be dissatisfied with the company. First is, their pay allowances are very low, not matching with the work what they are doing. And the second one, they are having certain rules which are being imposed on them, which are questioning against their religious beliefs. Many of them believe that when we cross the sea, we lose our purity of the nation. So they don't want to go to any overseas projects when the company requires them. In 1824, a similar situation has arrived when they have to go to Burma. Many of them agreed to go to Burma through land route, but not through waterways. And in 1856, the company made a rule that compulsory, whoever is looking up or taking up a job in the company has to serve as per the company's requirement. If the company requires you in abroad, in the overseas assignments, you need to cooperate and go ahead and take the task. Like this, there is dissatisfaction among the peasants and among the soldiers. The peasants are unhappy because the taxes are very high, the crop is not up to the mark, and they are following very rigid methods of collection of the taxes. But when it comes to the Indian sepoys, their pace are not matching with their work, and they are also having new rules which are questioning or against the religious sensibilities. And also, in 1824, when they were asked to move to Burma, people, many of them, rejected to go by waterways because they have to cross the sea. They preferred to go by land route. And in 1856, the company made a new rule stating that if any of the individual takes up a job in the company, has to serve the company as per its requirement. There is no exclusion given to any of the individuals basing on their religious basis or any other reason. If they have to serve abroad, they have to go to overseas and serve and take up the job. Otherwise, they will not allow them to take the job. Like this, the Indian farmers and the peasants are highly dissatisfied, and most of the soldiers are also peasants. Background in the villages, back the families are doing farming, and these rules, these regulations frustrated the peasant community and also the farmer community as well as the sipai community. That's why the revolt spread like a wild fire, not only in the sipais but also among the peasants. Responses to the reforms. The Britishers believed largely that Indian society has to be reformed. In India, the people are not civilized as per the Europeans' people. So what are the things that they have brought to reform Indian society? First, stop sati system. We had a system in practice where if a husband passes away, the wife will be burnt alive with the dead body of the husband. So burning of the wife with the dead body of the husband, that system is known as sati system. So Britishers passed a new law stating stop sati system. If you follow the sati system, you are liable for punishment. And moving on to the next one, encourage remarriage of widows. They used to marry very young girls to very old men. A 10 to 12 years old girl will be married to 45 to 60 years of age old man. So as age crosses on, he passes away, and these girls either be followed the sati system, will be burnt, or they used to make them as widows. So Britishers passed new laws to encourage these kind of young widows to get married again. So widow remarriages were allowed by the Britishers. Then English education. The English education system has started to be implemented from 1830s in order to modernize the Indians and to make them to get connected with the other parts of the world. Once they learn English, then only they will know what is the importance of English, and they can read the other literary sources, and the requirement of the clerical staff will also be fulfilled if Indians are getting educated. And moving on, the Christian missionaries were allowed freely to establish their own convents, hospitals, and do the services to the society. In 1815, the law of conversion to Christianity was made much, much easier so that people get attracted towards Christianity. And these all, like the destruction of the sati system, the encouraging of the remarriage of the widows, English education, stopping the Vedic education, Christian missionaries, schools, colleges, establishment, conversion to Christianity was being much made easier by 1850s. So these all traditional people thought that they are doing religious destruction. Social customs and traditional way of life are getting destroyed by the Britishers. People started to assume that they are not only destroying our day-to-day life, livelihood, but they started to peep in into our day-to-day life customs, day-to-day life behavioral attitude, day-to-day life traditions which we are following are now slowly getting influenced by the Britishers. They want to stop the sati system which we are following from many centuries. They want to break up the laws of widows not to get married. They want to encourage the widows to get married again, which is a really not acceptable to the Hindus at that point of time. English education has to be introduced, which means the traditional education has been discouraged. And Christian missionaries, the foreign religion is being introduced in the country, and they started to set up freely their hospitals, their institutions, their churches and everything. Stop to Christianity conversion was made very easy. So now we want to convert into Christian is very easy aspect from 1850 as the law was being changed. And religious destruction, social customs, traditional way of life, they started to destroy all these things. So the people started to feel very much angry, annoyed and dissatisfied. So people start wanted to rebel against the government's moves. There the peasants are destroyed. The soldiers are unhappy with the government's policies, especially the company's policies. Now the people are also not happy because British start to impose their will over the people. A mutiny becomes a popular rebellion. How did it become a popular rebellion? What is the meaning of the word mutiny? Sepoy mutiny is a commonly generally we hear. So when an armed officer gives an order, when all the soldiers, a group of soldiers, did not follow the order and rebel against the commander, that is called mutiny. So the rulers versus the ruled is not unusual in the society from the ancient period to the modern period. So rulers and the ruled fighting between each other was a common phenomenon, at least from 18th century, where people started to rebel against the monarchies and all. Now some are widespread across the countries and this drove the attention of the people towards itself. So some people really are very confident, and many of the masses, like thousands of people, concluded that we have a common enemy and we all need to fight against the common enemy. So coming here, common enemy, they want to fight against the common enemy here. Who is the common enemy? For all the Indians, the common enemy is the Britishers. So people, in order to fight against a mighty power, we need to organize on ourselves. We need to be systematic. We need to communicate with each other. We need to spread the message that we all are one and we are fighting against them. We need to take initiative. You need to go ahead and run the task, and you should have confidence that you can fight against them. First, you should be organizing. Second, you should be communicative. Third, you should be initiated person. And fourth, you should have confidence. Other than this, you should be having a common enemy to face. And company faced massive rebellion after a century, after it has established its trade posts here. That was the date on 10th of May 1857. The rebellion took place in Meerut. The soldiers refused to do the act given by the commander, the military commander. So this kind of resistance by a group of soldiers against the commander is known as mutiny. This is considered one of the most widely spread mutiny and the largest mutiny in the 19th century. So what happened in Meerut and how did it reach to the northern parts of the country? Where did it stop? How did the Britishers respond to this? How many months it took for the Britishers to stop this one? What are the consequences of this? What are the aftermath effects? Let's find out all this in detail now. From Meerut to Delhi, it was the date on 29th of March 1857. Mangal Pandey, a soldier, was hanged to death because he disobeyed the orders of his commander. And this happened in a place called Barakpur. As the situations passed on, a couple of days later, soldiers refused to perform the drill because there was a new cartridge. The new cartridge was being made of a plastic coated cover over that. That cover is made up of the fat combination of pig and cow. So in order to load the gun, the cartridge seal has to be broken up by the mouth, and then that has to be placed into the gun, which means here the cartridge is covered with the seal made with the fat of cow and pig. Cow is considered as a holy animal for the Hindus. Pig is considered something which should not be touched by the Hindus, sorry, by the Muslims. So these two combination frustrated the soldiers of the Hindus as well as the Muslims. So now Mangal Pandey was hanged to death because he refused to do the filling of the cartridge, and later many of the soldiers refused to perform any drill using these cartridges. With this, the angry Britishers suspended 85 people and sentenced them for 10 years of jail. This happened on 9th of May 1857. As the situation became worse, now all the other soldiers got very much angry, because here the Britishers are crossing the limit and started to elevate the religious sentiments of the Hindus as well as Muslims. Till now, the soldiers are unhappy only with the pay commissions, only with the pay allowances with them. They are unhappy with the new rules like passing across the sea and working somewhere abroad, which they were managing, they were disobeying slightly. But as the time passed on, now a new cartridge which is made up with the fat of cow and pig has to be removed with their own mouths. So this made the soldiers to get frustrated. When they did not obey to do this one, they were imprisoned and sentenced for jail for 10 years, and they were suspended from their services. This all made the other soldiers to take it very seriously. On the 10th of May 1857, as I told earlier, all the soldiers attacked Meerut prison, the Meerut jail, blasted the Meerut jail doors and entered inside, killed the officers, seized the ammunition and took away all the prisoners into their custody and released them freely. And in the meanwhile, when the soldiers wanted to do this rebellion, some of them also went overnight journey, riding whole across the night, and reached to Delhi. And when they were going there, the soldiers also raised in the rebellion and supported the soldiers who revolted against the Britishers, because these all people started to view the Britishers as a common enemy. If now Britishers are to be destroyed, Britishers' power has to be removed, Britishers has to be sent away, who will be able to rule us? Who will be the alternative to rule us? This is the big question in the minds of the soldiers. The soldiers have a clear, straight perspective and a clear agenda for that. What was that? They had a clear point that they don't want the British rule. They want the Mughal ruler, Bahadur Shah Jafar, to take over the initiative, fight against the Britishers and become the alternative ruler for them. So they drove from Meerut to Delhi whole across the night and reached Delhi in the early hours. And many of the soldiers gathered there. They requested to enter inside. Finally, they came inside and persisted the Mughal emperor to agree and give his blessings. The Britishers never thought that the cartridge which was being issued by them would create such a massive rebellion. They thought this would create some disturbances which can be erased off within a few couple of days. But when they got the blessings of Mughal emperor, the Mughal emperor blessed the rebellion and took over the leadership. And he also wrote a letter inviting all the kings, princes, chieftains and everybody to form a confederacy and fight against the Britishers. With this, all the chieftains, Samantas, nobles and the other kings, Rajputs, everybody, whoever is ruling in the entire nation, started to come under a single umbrella and started to fight against the Britishers. So what happened then? Did the Britishers defeat Indians, or the Mughal Empire was able to defeat the British soldiers? What happened in the mill? What were the consequences of this one? After taking the blessings from the Mughal Emperor Bahadur Shah Jafar, the aging emperor initially was not reluctant to take over the leadership, but the soldiers persisted him to take the initiative and be the next alternative and drive away the Britishers. So then the Bahadur Shah Jafar has agreed and taken the initiative and blessed the rebellion. With this, the soldiers got the hope and made them to be confident, and then they fought. Along with he taking up the leadership, he also requested all the Indian Rajputs, kings, his chieftains, nobles, nawabs, everybody to rebel against the Britishers so that we can drive them away. And many of them are now considering Bahadur Shah Jafar, Mughal Emperor, the most positive possible alternative. And once, if Mughals can rule again, the local nawabs, the local chieftains, the local kings will again uphold the Mughal Emperor, ensure their suzerainty, and then subdue themselves to the Mughal rulers. So they also can rule their own parts. That's why all started to support them. It took time to spread the news that the rebellion started to spread in various parts. As like today, the communication network was not so much improved during those days. So it took a lot of time for the rebellion to spread and the news to spread over there. But in the regiments, one regiment after the other regiment, at the nodal points, in Delhi, Kanpur and Lucknow, started to rebel against the British officials and fight in the rebellion. Not only the soldiers, many people who are dissatisfied with the high collection of the taxes and the rigid methods of tax collection, they also started to fight with the Britishers in the towns and also in the villages. Not only this, the people, those who were frustrated, suffered the British policies, also started to join back and fight the rebellion here. Nana Saheb, the adopted son of Peshwa Bajira, who was living in Kanpur, gathered the armed forces, led a garrison, drove away the Britishers, and declared himself as a Peshwa, and also declared that he is a governor under Mughal Emperor Bahadur Shah Jafar, which means he directly gave support for the Mughals' leadership. Not only he, we also have in Lucknow Birji Qadir, who is the son of Wazid Ali Shah, who was a Nawab earlier, and his wife Begum Hazrat also took active part in this. Not only in Lucknow, in Jhansi we have Rani Lakshmi Bai fighting with Nana Saheb's commander Tandia Top against the Britishers in the rebellion. And with this, the Britishers lost many of the battles because most of the soldiers are Indians and supporting the Indian people to fight against the Britishers. British collapsed. This gave the confidence for the Indians that with now the Britishers are collapsed. We also have new leaders coming up. Ahmadullah Malvi Sahab, who was a religious person who motivated many hundreds of people. He is from Faizabad. He came to Lucknow to fight against the rebellion. We also have Bakht Khan from Bareilly, who was a leader of a large regiment of soldiers who took the initiative to fight against the rebellion, to fight against the Britishers, not against the rebellion, part of the rebellion. And in Bihar, we have Kunwar Singh, who was once the Nawab and who worked as a Nawab here. So he also started to fight back. So every corner in Delhi, in Meerut, in Lucknow, in Bareilly, in Bihar, every part you can see the old kings, Nawabs or any other zamindar who worked and suffered with the British rule started to uphold their suzerainty with the Mughals, declared Mughal rule official, positive. So with this, the rebellion started to spread like a wildfire. What happened? How did the Britishers fight back this? So the company fight backs. How did the company fight back? In order to suppress the revolts, it used all its might, strength and repressed the revolt. They want to press it down to the bottom and erase it from the history of India. How is it possible? They want to weed out everything whoever rebelled against them, they want to finish off them and recapture every place again. For this, they got the reinforcement from England and they passed new laws which gives them freedom to arrest anyone and end up anyone's life, hang them to death. As the laws were passed, first the target was Delhi. Delhi was recaptured by the Britishers from the rebellion forces. And the last Mughal emperor, Bahadur Shah Jafar, was given sentenced to death, like life imprisonment, in the Rangoon jail in Burma till 1862, because in 1862 he has passed away. And in 1858, when this capturing happened, Bahadur Shah Jafar's sons were killed in front of his own eyes to show that there is no any Mughal ruler after him. And many sepoys, rajas and nawabs were caught. Lucknow was recaptured in the March 1858. Rani Lakshmi Bai was killed in June 1858. Tantia Top tried to escaped into the jungles and tried to fight through the guerrilla warfare and establish himself as a peasant leader, but in April 1859 he was killed. The Britishers now step by step started to recapture Delhi, Kanpur, Lucknow, Jhansi, every region, killing off all the leaders who emerged as the new leaders and rebellious leaders. So they also want to be loyal to the people. They told that if you are handing over yourself to the Britishers and did not kill any white people, there will not be any action taken against you. No land grabbing will happen for you. But in spite of this, many of the sepoys, rajas and nawabs were tried and hanged to death. But just capturing Delhi did not stop the spirit of rebellion in the people. A massive change has happened after the 1857 revolt. What are those changes? What are the administrative changes that brought in after this 1857 revolt? Aftermath. What happened after the rebellion has taken place? The company has tried to destroy all the rebellious troops, recapture Delhi, Lucknow, Bihar, every place. So what are the changes that happened after this recapturing? The first massive change, British regained the control by the end of 1859, but with this, sudden changes are being implemented because the new parliament has passed new laws. That is, the transfer of the power from the English East India Company to the British Crown, so that the Indian administration, the management, will be more responsible. So responsible management of the Indian affairs can be taken care of by the British system, not a particular company. So with this, the English East India Company, which came to do trade with India, lost its hold over Indian lands, and the British Crown has taken over the entire leadership and the administrative matters of the Indian lands, so that they can provide some responsible management to look into the Indian affairs. The secretary and an Indian council were established. The secretary to look into the affairs of India, and an Indian council, a team of members, are given to assist him in taking his decision. Not only this, the Governor General, till the company's rule, we have many Governor Generals. This Governor General post has been got renamed as the Viceroy of the British Queen, and he has become the direct authoritative person only to the Crown. Along with this, there are certain other provisions added for this one. No annexations. Even if they don't have their natural born son, they don't have their natural heir, their kingdoms will not be annexed by the Britishers. They can adopt sons, provided if they agree to the British policies. So there is no policy of doctrine or doctrine of lapse. Means if you don't have a natural born son, your kingdom will be annexed by the Britishers. So that was being banned and stopped. More European soldiers will be introduced into the Indian army. the number of the Indian soldiers will be reduced as the time passed on, and more European soldiers will be brought in here. Along with this, instead of recruiting soldiers from Bihar, Delhi, Meerut, Barakpur, other regions, they decided to take soldiers from the other community groups like Gurkhas, Sikh community and the Pathan groups. The Muslims were looked with great suspicion. Most of the properties of the Muslims are being confiscated and taken out, and many of them were killed. Along with this, British started to decide to respect the customary beliefs of the Indian Hindus, especially the religious laws, and they also made certain laws to protect the zamindar and the landlord land rights, so that they can have the right or their land protected without any disturbances. And with this, a new phase has begun after 1857 over the Indian administration. So in this lesson, we have discussed how did the people react when the Britishers started to impose new laws. There are laws which declared the landlords and the zamindars to collect high taxes, and rigid methods with the collection of the taxes is happening. With this, many of the peasants who could not pay back the loans started to suffer. And the date of 10th May 1857, a historical date, 10th May 1857 is considered to be a historical move when it comes to Indian history. On that day, many soldiers marched to the prison of Meerut, destroyed the prison, jail, attacked the British officials, released the 85 prisoners, the soldiers who are being kept as prisoners. Why are these soldiers kept as prisoners? We have to go back to 9th of March 1857, when Mangal Pandey resisted his officer, rebelled against his officer. He was hanged to death on that day. Many of the Indian soldiers, after a couple of weeks, decided not to do the practices with the cartridges which are made with the fat of pig and cow covered with that. So when this kind of rebellions started to take place, the English Britishers has imposed life sentence for them for 10 years and imprisoned them. With this, the angry soldiers attacked the jail, brought them back, and along with this, the people, some of them have drove themselves to Delhi over the entire night and persisted the Mughal Emperor Bahadur Shah Jafar to take the initiative and to bless them and to be an alternative leader, to emerge as an alternative leader. Once he took over the leadership and blessed the armed rebellion, then he wrote a letter to all the Nawabs, all his officials who are working under him, all the Indian kings, Rajputs and everybody, and he asked them to form a confederacy, fight against the Britishers, to drive them away. Slowly, one after the other, the soldiers started to occupy and capture Delhi, Lucknow, Jhansi and many other prominent figures. Nana Saheb, many of them declared their suzerainty to the Mughal Emperor. They agreed to be the governors of Mughal rule. But as the time passed on, the English people, the company started to fight back. They got the reinforcements from the England and they started to get external support. They started to fight back slowly. First, they recaptured Delhi in 1858 and they killed all the sons of the Mughal Emperor in front of his own eyes. And later, he was sentenced to jail for 10 years and he was taken to Burma, the Rangoon. And in jail in 1862, he passed away. Later they occupied Lucknow. Later they occupied all the other Meerut and every region. With this occupation, there are certain more changes which happened after this. Some of the changes are British regained control by the end of 1859. And the changes, the transfer of the power from the English East India Company to the Crown. With this, India became a Crown colony from 1859. A new law has transferred the power from the company's rule to the crown's rule. The responsible management is a main motto of this transfer of power from company to the crown. There are certain additional posts added to this. Indian secretary has been appointed with a council of people to assist him, known as Indian Council. The Governor General name got transformed as Viceroy, and they also had promised that there would not be any forceful annexations happening who agreed to the Queen's rule, and more European soldiers would be brought into the Indian army, and the Indian soldiers will be recruited not from Delhi, Meerut or Bihar. They will be taken from Gurkhas, Sikh and Pathans, and they also taken care that Muslims will not be having large spread. They started to corrupt the Muslim properties, eradicate the Muslims, because Muslims are looked with great suspicion. Massive rebellion took place under the able leadership of Bahadur Shah Jafar. That is the main reason why the Muslims are looked with great suspicion. And the respect for the customary laws was taken as a major initiative when it comes to the changes after 1857. The Britishers decided to respect the customary laws of the Indian Hindus, especially the religious laws, the social beliefs and everything. The zemindars and the landlords were given the protection rights of their lands. With this, we can see a new phase of beginning after 1857. These are the important points what we have discussed in this unit.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.